Right. Our next topic is what? Hooke's law. We had two things we completed in the last classes, stress and strain. Roughly speaking, stress is nothing but how much effect is there. I mean, how much force is applying, and strain is nothing but how much effect it is gaining on it, right? So, based on those two things, we will be defining our Hooke's law. That is, so the extension produced in the wire is directly proportional to the strain applied within elastic limit. Ikkada oka word miss ayindi, stress applied. So I will write that. Just a minute. Right. So proportional to the applied what? Stress. So if we apply stress, we have seen in all the examples, if we apply stress, we will be getting strain in the body, right? It may be longitudinal, or it may be tangential, or it may be volumetric. So stress corresponds to particular strain. So we are saying that the extension produced in the wire, when we are applying force in it, it will be producing some extension in any of the form. That extension is directly proportional to the stress applied within elastic limit. So extension is nothing but what? Strain. Strain. So our strain is directly proportional to, means our strain is depending on stress. That means stress is directly proportional to strain. How much stress we apply, that much change will be produced, that much change in configuration is produced. Change in configuration only we call it as a strain. Okay. Now, so based on this, if we speak the relation between stress and strain, we can speak here now. So that if we check, we will have a relation between stress as well as a strain. Now, so that if we continue, so within elastic limit, the stress developed is directly proportional to the strain produced. Change in its configuration is nothing but strain only. The force which we are applying will be resulting into stress. So stress is directly proportional to strain in the body. Now, that if we write, so what we can write? Stress is directly proportional to strain. Whenever we have proportionality, we can remove it and we can place a constant by removal of that. So what we can write? Stress is directly proportional to some constant E I am considering and into strain. If I write an expression for this E, what do we get? So E is equals to stress, and the strain will go down. E is equals to stress by strain. This E, whatever we have, this E we call it as coefficient of elasticity or elastic modulus we call. Okay. Now, so E is what? E is coefficient of elasticity, or we can also call it as elastic modulus. Or modulus of elasticity also we can call. Okay. So coefficient of elasticity or elastic modulus. So what does it mean? What does E mean? So how much stress can be applied to get certain amount of strain? So every object will have its own elastic coefficient value. That elastic modulus value, if it is more, it will be, that elastic property will be more. Okay. Elastic property is more means it can be extended more in it. So the extension produced in a material will be more if elastic constant is more. If elastic constant is less, only less extension can be produced. So in case of rubber bands, this elastic coefficient will be more. It can be elongated, or extension produced in that will be more. Okay. So whereas if you take a chalk piece, that for that material, elastic coefficient will be very less. So if I apply little amount of force, it will be breaking, right? So all that elastic nature depends on what? This coefficient of elasticity only, right? So based on this coefficient of elasticity, total elastic nature depends. And that coefficient of elasticity depends on what? Stress and strain. So coefficient of elasticity is defined as stress by strain. Okay. So that is Hooke's law. Hooke's law gives limit for this elastic nature. How long we can pull any object. Okay. How much its elastic nature will be there. That will be given in terms of Hooke's law. Hooke's law gives limit to the elastic nature. Clear? And now we will take one, what we call some wire we'll be taking, and to the wire we will check how the elastic nature will be. Okay, now we'll go with that. This is important 4 marks question, whatever we are going to cover now, right? So stress strain curve I am speaking now. This stress strain curve is a important question. So in this what we do actually, I will draw a short diagram over here, then we can explain with that. I have here some surface, fixed surface. I have to draw it straight line. There it is. I have some fixed support here. To that fixed support, what we do, so we will be taking one wire like arrangement like this, and to this what we do, we will be attaching some mass to it. Okay, so mass is attached. So if we attach mass to any wire, what happens? This mass will be, some weight will be acting on it in this downward direction. So that means this weight is pulling this wire. So when this wire is pulled, so we have an arrangement here, we can change this mass. This is a variable mass. That means we can change continuously. We can add some masses or we can remove some masses, just like weighing machine. Normally we will purchase vegetables from the same way, we can add or we can remove some weights from it. So we will check. First I am applying very less amount of value. So keep in mind, this is important 4 marks question in case of IPE. So listen carefully. So what we are doing, we have taken a wire, we attached it to one fixed end. Then what we are doing, we are just checking it, how the wire changes when we are increasing our load, increasing our masses, our weight will, this particular object weight will increase. When weight of that is increasing, what happens to the wire? What happens to the wire? It is nothing but, this is pulling downwards, right? So this wire is pulled by this downwards. When it is pulled, when this wire is pulled by this, so what happens? Extension will be produced in this. How the extension changes as soon as we increase the weights, we will check. Okay, so that we will check with a graphical arrangement. We'll see stress versus strain. Okay, directly I have drawn complete diagram. Now gradually we'll check. So I am taking strain on the x-axis and stress on y-axis. Okay. So I hope you could see the diagram clearly. So in this, so what is happening? Initially, from here we are starting. Gradually I am increasing stress, strain also increasing. That means I am increasing load gradually. So what is happening? The extension is gradually increasing in this. Slowly, slowly it is coming down. Okay. So up to where? Up to a point A. Up to certain amount of masses when we are adding. Up to certain amount of masses. Suppose example we will take here to for better understanding. What I am doing? So I have taken some 1 kg mass, then it is increasing 2 kg, 3 kg, like that up to some 10 kg I added. Up to 10 kg, what is happening? So extension is producing, and here stress increasing, strain also changing. Stress is increasing, strain is changing, gradually it is changing up to point A. So up to this, what we call, we took it as a point A, right? Next to what is happening, if I remove weights, if I remove these masses, if I remove 10 kg, if it is coming up to 8 kg, then again it will, extension will be going back. That means it will regain back to its original shape. Okay, so that means this wire is having some elastic nature. So up to certain limit, up to this point A, it will regain back to its original shape, original state. So this particular point A, we are calling it as proportional limit. See here, proportional limit. Proportional limit means what? As the stress is increasing, strain is also increasing gradually, right? So if I remove any of our masses, it will regain back to its original shape. Next, what we are doing? Still above 10 kg, still I am applying 11 kg, I applied 12 kg, I applied. So still extension is producing, but how much stress is produced, that much strain is not there. Little more strain is there. Okay, so more strain is there. This side it is coming, no, little more strain we are getting up to point B. And up to this point also, stress is not directly proportional to strain, but elastic limit is there. Up to where? Up to 12 kg, up to point B, elastic limit is there. That means if I again remove this 12 kg weight, if I remove 2 more kgs, if I bring back to 10 kg, again it will come back. That means it will go back. Up to where? Up to 12 kg elastic limit is present. Up to A point also elastic limit present, up to B point also elastic limit present. What is the difference between A and B? Up to A, proportional limit is there. How much stress if I apply, that much strain is producing. Okay, but whereas from A to B, if I apply little stress also, strain produced is more. Okay, it is not in proportional limit from A to B. So from A to B, what is happening? Elastic limit is there, but it is not changing according to stress directly proportional to strain. And this particular point, whatever we reached point B, up to where we have elastic limit, that particular point we are calling it as yield point. Okay, so yield point, up to yield point we completed. Up to in the example I am taking, up to where? Up to 12 kg I got yield point. So yield means some change is produced, right? Next, what we are doing, still some more masses we are adding, 13 kg 14 kg we are adding. So when we are adding, what happens? Extension is produced. If I remove that 13 kg mass, whatever 1 kg I am applying after this, if I remove that, it should not come back to B. That means their elastic nature has lost. Up to here only it's a elastic limit is there. Okay, so up to A point only Hooke's law is valid. Up to B, even though Hooke's law is not valid, up to B elastic nature is present in it. Once B point is crossed, once 12 kg mass is exceeded, once 13 kg mass is added, 13 kg 14 kg, it will change, it will deform. The wire is extending, it is becoming thin. So at a particular point C, what is happening? Its change is produced in it. Okay, change is produced in it. Then, just a minute. So change is produced in it. And then what is happening? Elastic limit is crossed, change is produced in it up to C point, 13 kgs, 14 kgs when I am adding. So the wire is becoming thin. So for a particular point C, I am locating some point where elastic limit is crossed. That particular point C, we call it as extension. How much extension is produced means 1%. Okay. More than 1% extension is produced. That means 10 meters wire, if I consider, it became 11, more than 11 meters it became. That means more than 1 meter extension is produced in it. That means more than 1%. In 10 meters, 1% means 1 meter. More than 1%, that means more than 11, the change has taken place in the string. If more than 1%, if it is increasing, means it will come to a point called C. Okay, so this particular point C, we call it as permanent set. Permanent set, that means beyond that, whatever change is happening, it will remain in the same state only. Okay, sorry, extension produce ante ante means whatever leaningness is happening in the wire, thin it will become, no? So it will become thin only. If we remove the weights, it will no more coming back to the previous states. Okay, next. So C point is called a permanent set. After C, some more weights if I add, up to 14 kgs we have come, no? So if I remove more than 14 kgs, if I apply, more than 14 kgs if I apply, if I come to point D, around some 17 kgs up to IKM. Okay, if I come up to 17 kgs, there is a point called D. that point D we call it as point D, we are calling it as a permanently deformed state, we call SUE we are calling, no? So this permanently deformed state, there we cannot come back to original state, then that means permanently it is deformed at this particular point D. Then after D, if I apply little amount of force, it will come to a point called E. So that means after D 19 kgs, up to 19 kgs I applied, that means it is became very thin, almost like what we call like hair, it became that much thin, it became above 19 kg. If I apply 1 gram also, if I apply 1 gram little amount of mass also, if I apply, it will break. So this particular value, maximum value up to where it can withstand is 19 kg. This 19 kg point we are calling it as fracture point or breaking point. If we add little amount of force also, it will break, right? So that is what we are calling it as fracture point. Okay, so that is complete information about how a wire behaves under gradually increasing load. Okay, behavior of wire under gradually increasing load. This particular curve, we call it as a stress-strain curve. Stress-strain curve is important to study the behavior of a wire. Now, and this particular point is the D point. D point, we didn't name it. No, this point we call it as a tensile point. Tensile point. Okay. So these are the different points which we have in the curve. So this we call it a stress-strain curve. So where this we get this fracture, where this D point we will get, means when 30% change it has come, that means 10 meters is there. That means when the wire becomes 13 meters, that means it is gradually going into breaking point. Okay, so this fracture point or breaking point we call here. Clear? Right. So if you have any more doubts in it, you can ask, so that I will go with the next topic. Just hold on. Right. So elastic moduli already we have written in case of Hooke's law. So that is E is equals to stress by strain we have written. But what we have, stress, we have three types of stress. Each corresponding stress is having corresponding strain also. That means longitudinal stress by longitudinal strain will have one elastic moduli. So tangential stress by shearing strain also will have one more elastic moduli. Based on that, as we have three types of stress and three types of strain, we will be having three types of elastic moduli. Okay, that if we check, so what do we get now? So based on that, if we check elastic moduli, modulus of elasticity or elastic moduli is defined as what? The ratio of stress to the corresponding strain produced within elastic limit. That is what we have written in Hooke's law also. That ratio we are calling it as elastic moduli or modulus of elasticity, E, right? Coefficient of elasticity, all those are same. Now, so stress is directly proportional to strain. Stress is equals to E into strain. There I have taken small e, here I am taking capital E, doesn't matter. Now, so E is equals to what? Stress by strain. Now, so based on three types of stress and three types of strain, we will be having three types of elastic moduli. Okay, so that is Young's modulus of elasticity, bulk modulus of elasticity, modulus of rigidity, rigidity modulus or shear modulus of elasticity we call. Okay, bulk, this is related to volume, this is related to tangential. We have written in the reverse order here. First one is linear, longitudinal stress by longitudinal. This bulk is volumetric, this is tangential. One by one we will see, we will understand clearly. Okay, so one by one, if you see, three types of stress, three types of strain we have. Based on that, three types of modulus we have. Okay, now one by one if you see. Let me check. Hmm. first part in it is Young's modulus. So Young's modulus, if we write. Why we will write Young's modulus if I write. So Young's modulus is what? Longitudinal stress by longitudinal strain we call. Right? So stress by strain is our elastic moduli. Young's modulus we are denoting with Y. Y is equals to. So what we are writing? So longitudinal stress by longitudinal strain. Now. So that is longitudinal stress by longitudinal strain. This ratio we call it as a Young's modulus, but we have formula for this. So longitudinal stress means what? F by A, right? Whatever stress, F by A only. And longitudinal strain is change in length by original length, change in extension by original extension also we can call. So that means change in extension, if I consider it as E, original extension if it is L, delta L I am taking it as E, E by L. So now what we can write, Y is equals to F into L by A into E, we can write F into L by E into A, we can write. This is a longitudinal stress by longitudinal strain is giving us Young's modulus. Okay, now Young's modulus we got. When we are applying force on an object along lengthwise, this is what responsible for its elastic nature, Young's modulus. Okay, next one. Next one is what? We will go with the bulk modulus, as in the order bulk modulus is there. So if we go with bulk modulus, bulk modulus, I am indicating with capital B here. So for this if we write, so what do we get? Bulk modulus is indicated by B. So in that bulk modulus B is equals to what we can write? Volume stress by volume strain. Volume stress by volume strain. Right? So volume stress by volume strain. This is for total. Bulk means total. Now, volume stress is what? B is equals to, if we write. So F by A is, this won't change anyhow. Whatever stress it is, F by A only is our formula. And this will change. Delta V by V it becomes. Okay? Delta V by V. Here I am considering one minus sign because the total volume will be compressed, no? So because compression, decreasing means we are writing minus sign here. Okay. Here elongation I have taken, so no minus. Here compression, decreasing. So I am taking minus here. Now in terms of that, if we write, so B is equals to what do we get? F by F into V. F into V by minus F into V by A into delta V. Delta V into A or A into delta V. This is what we can write. Don't cancel V. This is change in volume. Right. So that is bulk modulus value. Right. Next, shear modulus or rigidity modulus will be there. Rigidity modulus we will indicate with N. N if we write. So rigidity modulus if we write. That what we will write? Tangential stress by tangential strain we will write. That is about rigidity modulus. So tangential stress formula F by A only. And the strain produced is E by L, we will write. Okay, so that is about rigidity modulus. Rigidity modulus, if we write. Now, so what do we write? Rigidity modulus is equals to rigidity modulus, we'll write eta, which is equals to tangential stress. Tangential stress by shearing strain or tangential strain, shearing strain, or simply we can write shear also. Shear means shearing strain only. So what we will write? F by L, sorry, F by A by E by L or delta L by L, we can write. This is about rigidity modulus. So three types of modulus of elasticity also we have completed. Okay, right. I'll close here. We will continue the little problematic part and remaining two, three topics, small topics are there. So those will complete by tomorrow. We'll complete this chapter. Okay, up to IP level. Right. So I'll close here.